Welcome students. So in previous session we have learned about physical properties of metals and non-metals, where I told you malleability, ductility, melting point, boiling point, many physical properties of metals and non-metals. But we cannot differentiate metals and non-metals on the behalf of physical property only. So let's begin the next session, that is chemical properties of metals and non-metals. So that you have seen in your daily routine life also, ki how metal reacts with air, acids, base and another salts. But here we need to understand what is reactivity series, how metals are reactive. So here again I am having one trick. I have written over here metal reactivity series. So here I have written one trick also, but the names you have to learn properly. So here I have written potassium, sodium, calcium, magnesium, aluminium, zinc, iron, tin, lead, hydrogen, copper, mercury, silver, gold and platinum. How you will learn this? Please send cages. My amazing zoo in Thailand loves horses, cats, monkeys, snakes, giraffe and penguins. So how this is how metals are reactive. What is reactivity series? Reactivity series where elements are arranged in a vertical column in decreasing order. It means the elements which are placed at the top, for an example potassium and sodium, they are most reactive elements. Okay, so they can react easily with air, water, acids and bases. And at the bottom, that is gold and platinum, they are least reactive metals which cannot react easily with air, water and acids and bases. Okay, so you have seen one example also, that is golden temple of Amritsar. That's why that is made up of from gold, because that is least reactive metal that cannot be react with acids and air and oil. Understood this much? Because here this is vertical column reactivity series and the elements which are placed at the top, they are most reactive, so they can react easily. Okay, they can displace the another element easily, and at the bottom one is least reactive elements. Okay, so let's start metals with oxygen and so here metals, when metals react with oxygen, so I told you according to the reactivity series which is at the top, they will react easily, and the elements which are at the bottom, they will react, they cannot react easily. So here I place magnesium and they react with oxygen, it forms magnesium oxide. Don't be panic about how to balance the reaction. You can write the names also. Magnesium plus oxygen gives to magnesium oxide. You can write like this. Magnesium oxide. Because this you will learn in detail in 10th class. See here, this is called reactant. This is called reactant. And this is called product. Here how many molecules of magnesium? 2. And how many molecules of oxygen? 2. So here I have written 2 common for Mg and O. So this is balanced reaction. 2 Mg and 2 for O. 2 is common for O. So here this is balanced. Again I took the another metal, that is zinc. When zinc reacts with oxygen, it forms 2ZnO, zinc oxide. Okay, so again here 2 zinc, 2 Zn, 2 Zn, 2 oxygen, 2 oxygen. Again balanced reaction. Then again this is copper oxide. When copper reacts with oxygen, it forms copper oxide. Okay, but here magnesium, where it is present? Magnesium. Okay, sodium, magnesium, they will react vigorously with oxygen because they are most reactive elements, but copper is least reactive element, that's why it cannot be react easily with oxygen. Okay? Next thing is, whenever metal reacts with oxygen, they forms metal oxide. This is important for your class. Not these many equations that you have balanced in 7th class also. So what is important here? Whenever metal reacts with oxygen, they form metal oxide. Okay? Next is, when metal reacts with water, they form metal hydroxide. Okay? So here I have written potassium when it reacts with water. You know, potassium and sodium, they react vigorously with air and water. Why? Because they are most reactive metals. That's why we always place potassium and sodium in kerosene solution, because they react easily with air and water. So here, when potassium reacts with water, they forms 2KOH. This is called hydroxide that you have learned in 7th class. OH means hydroxide. 2KOH. Hydroxide and hydrogen gas will release. Okay. Here again I have taken one another element, that is magnesium. With water, it will form magnesium hydroxide plus hydrogen gas will evolve. So I told you, whenever metal reacts with water, it forms metal hydroxide plus hydrogen gas. Here you can do one trick also. This is reactant, you know, magnesium plus water, 2H2O. Okay, so first you can write hydrogen gas, because you know whenever metal reacts with water, it evolves hydrogen gas first. Okay, you can write over here hydrogen gas. So H2 evolves. So how many hydrogen is remaining? 2H is remaining, 2O is remaining, and Mg is remaining. So here I have written Mg OH whole twice. 2H and 2O was remaining. So Mg OH whole twice. Understood this equation? Okay, again I am telling you, don't be panic about balancing of reaction. Just keep it in your mind. What is important for your class? Metal reacts with water, it forms metal hydroxide plus hydrogen gas. Okay, how I come to know these metal hydroxides are basic in nature? When I placed red litmus paper in magnesium hydroxide solution, it turns into blue. That you have learned in 7th class. Whenever red litmus paper turns into blue, they call basic in nature. So they are basic in nature. Okay? Understood? Now we will learn when metal reacts with acids.